Hey guys, thank you so much for tuning in today. First of all, I just want to thank you so much for all your comments. Please keep them coming since it really encourages me to make more of these videos. I also want to help you guys learn as much as you can, so I've actually created a dedicated Facebook page where you can post your work or post any questions you might have for the community to answer. We're all on this XR journey together, so please like and subscribe and join our Facebook page so we can continue to make cool shit together. Anyway, here's your video.
Let's get started. So far, I've set up a scene, and in the scene, we've got the A-frame physics system ready to go, and we've got a camera and a plane as well as a sphere on top of the plane. The sphere has a dynamic body so that way it's free to move. All right, cool, so everything is ready to go. So if we refresh our page, we get a ball dropping from the sky, which is exactly what we'd expect. So I want to go through one thing before we dive into the coding, and it's that you can freely move around using drag, and you can use your, I'm tapping my keyboard right now, but basically you can use the keyboard to come closer and further and basically just control what angle you're looking at the scene, or more like you're controlling the camera of the scene. If you really think about it, the fact that you're able to use the keyboard and your mouse when you've got the A camera primitive implies that the A camera primitive actually has keyboard bindings, which is why today we're gonna remove it and replace it with the component version of A camera. So instead of A camera, I'm gonna put an A entity. Get rid of this, chuck the cursor back in the middle of it, and then we're simply gonna put a camera component there, and then we're gonna give the camera a position. So let's check what we've got now. We refresh the page. There, we pretty much got exactly the same thing, but maybe it's a slightly different perspective to the A camera default. All right, cool. So now, if you go back to this, I'm tapping on my keyboard right now. Hopefully you can hear the sound. Nothing's happening. I can't even rotate or do anything, and that's because we've used the camera component, which is not yet initialized. The goal of this lesson is to be able to move the sphere around the plane with our keyboard. So the first thing we'd look at is if A-frame has a keyboard primitive, right? Well, it turns out they don't really have a solution for that. So what do we have to do? We have to use ordinary JavaScript. To do that, I'm gonna open some script tags. And then we're going to try something really, really simple. Document.addEvent listener. And we want the key down event. We're interested in knowing what key it is, so we're going to add the function argument there. We have got our event listener. Now we want to do something really, really simple. We just want to make the ball move every time we tap the keyboard. First of all, we have to grab the component that we want to move. So let ball equals document dot query selector. We want to grab ID ball. So if you're setting this up, don't forget the ID so you can actually grab it on the event listener. Now I'm about to write a very scary looking line of code, but don't worry, we'll go over it slowly together. I'm gonna go ball dot body dot apply impulse cannon dot vic 3.0 new cannon.vic 3.0.0.0. Okay, I'm not going to explain this yet. Let's just see let's just see what happens here. Okay, so hopefully that works. Let's refresh the page. And then I'm going to press any key. And look, the ball goes up. And if I press and hold, it goes all the way up to the top. And sooner or later, it's going to drop. Every time we press any key, we're adding an impulse for the ball to go up. Okay, so let's go over what we just wrote. I'm not gonna go into Canon.js, but let me just explain the basics of it so you understand what's happening. So first of all, we got the element, and I'm sure you understood what this means. But within that element, we access something called body. What is body and where did it come from? So the clue is in the rest of the code. Here we've used an object called Canon. We all know that the physics library is built on top of Canon.js. So what that means is that any entity that we create with a physics body attached to it also has a Canon.js body attached to it. And because that's the case, we can access the APIs that body from Canon.js comes with, including impulse. I hope that sort of makes sense, and if it doesn't, what you can do is go to the Canon.js documentation. Let's go back to the code. Now we want to bind the keyboard events. So if you go if e.key, and instead of the up and down arrows, I want to use the ASDW keys. Okay, let's start with W. Need to create a new variable called impulse. It's new. Canon.vic3. Okay, so before I carry on, let me just explain this code, okay? This is the entity, which is the ball. The ball has a Canon.js body, which comes with the impulse function, and that impulse function takes in two parameters. So this vector tells you which direction that the impulse should go. So at the moment, it's 10 in the y-axis, so that's just going up. And then this is the world point to apply the force on, so we've set it at 000. So for this exercise, we won't be touching it. With that in mind, I'm going to create three if statements. So that's up, this is going to be down, this is going to be left, this is going to be right. So up is W, down is S, left is A, right is D. All right, let's make it prettier. Okay. And then what we're doing at the moment is we're trying to fill up these three vectors according to which direction that we've pressed. So I'm gonna go impulse dot. This is to do with the Z axis. So is the downwards direction. So this is going towards the camera. And then if we're going away from the camera, then we are minusing. Similarly, it's going to be plus. And then for right and left, that's going to be the X axis. A should be negative X, and this is positive X. And then there's one more thing we need to do. We need to replace this with our new variable. So let's remove this and call it impulse. Okay. And hopefully, fingers crossed, that actually works. Okay. There we go. Okay, I'm pressing A, D, S. So it's now going towards me. Oh, and it's fallen off. So that's way too quick. Let's change this to, let's create a new variable so we can play around with it here. So let's speed equals 5, and then change this. Oh, just making sure. To speed. Great. And so what happens now? Right, left. Oh, I have a feeling that apply force might be better. So let's change this to false. A, it's going ever so slowly, but now it's picking up speed. And then I'm gonna make it come closer to me, further away. Oh, and not fast enough, it's already gaining momentum. Anyway, you get the point. I accidentally closed the tab, so I guess the lesson is over. But hopefully you guys learned something today, and I'll see you all in the next lesson.
Hey guys, just a quick update. I've been super, super busy pivoting my business to focus more on AR and VR. There's gonna be a lot of new stuff coming, so please hit subscribe, like, and hit the notification bell so you can stay updated. Building the XR community on this channel really means a lot to me and brings me a lot of joy. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.